ready for the big show? Who was it that used to say the really big shoe? Ed Sullivan, right?
Y'all hear me?
Yes.
Okay, there we go. Well, are we ready? We are ready. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I am Dave Hoskins. I am happy to be your master of ceremonies for this evening. Now, under the direction of John Coffin and Jerry Hooper, please enjoy yesterday the songs of the 60s and 70s performed by the Colorado Chord Company.
Thank you.
Send to you all my love and darling.
this story will probably sound so familiar that you could substitute your name and the name of a high school sweetheart and relive your own story through the songs you're about to hear. It starts with Rick inviting Barb to the malt shop. It was their first date. Remember how you could play three songs for a quarter on the jukebox? Well, that you just heard was the first song that Rick selected, All My Loving by the Beatles. It was the first song that the Beatles sang on their first Ed Sullivan show appearance. Rick was hoping the songs he selected would let Barb know how he felt about her. Now the second song Rick selected, a hit song by the Lovin' Spoonful.
When ever I want.
Rick was just doing his best to drink his malt slowly. He had engaged in a little small talk about where he was from and what brought him to her hometown, and wanting to buy more time, he reached in his pocket and pulled out another quarter, and he selected a tune by the Drifters.
Sunshine of my life, that's why I'll always see around.
She enjoyed listening for his instrumental work when the band played at the high school football games. She knew the concert band would perform a few songs at the homecoming dance, so she told him that she loved clarinet melodies. She asked him if he would be playing at the dance. He told her that they were working on the songs for the dance and said, "You know, the Beatles had a song that featured the clarinet." He wondered if she could guess the name of the song written by Paul McCartney when he was 14 years old that featured a clarinet melody. Does anybody here know what that song is?
No, we do.
Nope.
Well, of course, the good giants. And he knew he would see her in history class and at the football game the next Friday night. maybe he could somehow manage to ask her to the dance on one of those occasions. Well, we'll find out what happens when the chorus returns. After a couple of numbers by the Crosstown Boomers.
There's a world where I can go to tell my secrets to, in my room, in my room, in my room. In this world I lock out all my worries and my fears, in my room, in my room. To return again.
When the song had finished, Barb said, "That's one of the greatest songs ever, but why did you choose it?" Rick said, "Well, at the end of the football game last night, you and the team captain hugged on the way to the locker room. Gee, I guess you two were pretty close." Barb felt Rick's anxiety and said, "Jack has been a friend of our family ever since my dad coached his Little League team. Jack heard my dad had a heart attack 2 weeks ago. He was just consoling me about my dad. And Jack's girlfriend is this year's homecoming queen." Rick expressed his sympathy, saying, "I'm so sorry to hear about your dad. I'm sure it's been a difficult 2 weeks for you. Good thing he's going to be okay." Now sensitive to Barb's revelation about her dad, Rick made his next jukebox selection this iconic song by Paul Simon, powerfully delivered by Art Garfunkel.
I'll try.
over, Rick tearfully confessed that he almost called off the date, having lost a lot of sleep the night before. But now that he understood what was going on, he selected B11 on the jukebox, a Beatles tune that was John Lennon's first attempt at a ballad, a song he called semi-autobiographical, about the true love that we all long for.
If I fell in love with you, would you promise to be true and help me understand? 'Cause I've been in love before, and I found that love is more than just holding hands. If I give my heart to you, I must be sure from the very start that you will love me more than her, more than her, if I trust in you. Oh, please, don't run and hide if I love you too. Oh, please, don't hurt my pride like her, 'cause I couldn't stand the pain, and I would be sad if our new love was in vain. So I hope you'll see that I would love to love you, and that she will cry when she learns we are two, 'cause I couldn't stand the pain, and I would be sad if our new love was in vain. So I hope you'll see that I, this guy, would love to love you.
Ended, Rick finally asked, "Barb, would you be my date at the homecoming dance?" Tearfully, Barb said, "Could I borrow a dime?" As she dropped it in the jukebox, she answered, "Of course I will," and selected this song by Louis Armstrong. And as the song began to play, she took Rick's hand in hers.
It's a glorious day, things are more than okay, and love makes me happy to say, to
hopefully longer. And she took the ring and slipped it on her finger. Since songs were working so well for him, Rick then dropped a dime in the jukebox and selected a love song that John Denver wrote for his wife Annie, all the while holding Barb's hand.
Ba 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 but I knew they wouldn't do Barber and Ba 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 Ba
Ba Ba Ba Ba Ba Ba
Ba Ba Ba Ba Ba Ba Ba Ba Ba Ba Ba Ba Ba Ba Ba Ba Ba Ba Ba Ba Ba Ba Ba Ba Ba Ba Ba Ba Ba Ba Ba Ba Ba Ba Ba Ba Ba Ba Ba Ba Ba Ba Ba Ba Ba Ba Ba Ba Ba Ba Ba Ba You got me rocking and rolling and reeling. You got me rolling and reeling and rocking. You got me ba 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 ba.
Country road.
hope you have enjoyed our presentation of Yesterday, Songs of the 60s and 70s. And please make a point of thanking your activity director, Sherry, for inviting us to perform for you. And we hope to see you in December for our Holiday Harmony presentation, The Season of Sharing. And we hope to bring you'll bring us back for an hour of love songs during the week of Valentine's Day in February. Once again, our directors, John Coffin and Jerry Hooper. And our quartet, Across Town Boomer. We are the Colorado Chord Company, and we hope to come back to sing for you again, again, and again, and real soon. Thank you.
Nobody really knows.
All right.
You make it up.
So we have melody singers, the lead singers. Raise your hand, lead singers.
There's only three of us today.
All right. Then we have the basses. Basses, raise your hand. Then you have the baritones. And then you have the tenor. Then that's how it does it. There you are. Thank you all.
Thank you.